change God in giving him the glory that is due unto his name, the praises and adoration. Only the living and the living can praise him. Those that are already in the grave can no longer celebrate the victory of the Lord Jesus. Sometimes we behave as if we created God. He didn't create us. As if we have control of things. We don't. It's God who determines who we live. He determines who we die. Because the breath in our nostrils is the one in charge. When he stops, he does it. When he takes that breath out, the Bible says they die. Hallelujah. I want to praise God with this song. Lord, I give you praise. And as I'm praising him with this song, you to sing your own song. We've been singing the songs God gave others to compose. Now it's time for you to sing your own song. Listen to my own song. King of kings, Lord of lords, holy is your name. All the earth must adore you, and you alone. You are precious in my sight, O God. Alpha and Omega, you are the one who was and is to come. King of kings, Lord of lords, holy is your name. All the earth must adore you, and you alone. You are precious in my sight, O God. Alpha and Omega, you are the one who was and is to come. I praise you. I honor you. And I adore you. Lord, I lift you up. I'm so grateful, Lord. I'm so thankful, Lord, for everything you've done. I'm so grateful, Lord, Abba Father. I'm so thankful, Lord, for everything you've done. Lord, I remain forever grateful for the gift of life you have given to me and preserving me from January the 1st to this moment. Glory, hallelujah. I adore you, God. I adore you, God. I cherish you. I love you because you are my refuge, my fortress, my strength, my buckler, my shield, my protector, my keeper, my sustainer, my defender. In your light I see light. You are my everything. You are my everything, oh Lord God. You are my everything, oh God. You are my everything, oh Lord God. You are my everything, 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 oh, oh God. Lord, you are my everything. Blessed be your glorious name. I adore you for tonight. No one can pray without you, eternal Holy Spirit. I welcome you. Take your rightful place and rightful position in this service. Our intercessor, our strengthener, our guide, our teacher, our leader, our comforter, our instructor, the revealer of the truth of God. Lord, no one can pray without you. Lord, tonight, you are strong. Lord, in your presence, I lose my relevance. You are my relevance. I am nothing. I can do nothing without you. Therefore, Lord, I am weak, but you are strong. And that is why you are the one that I need tonight. Oh, Lord, help us. Oh, and do bredi dida do de bredi de so di de reye e ku bredi da ba ya da sata ya do de bredi da ba ya nkori ororo sata ya. Now let the Lord say, what have been hindering you is you refuse to tell the truth at all times. Say, stop lying and then you will receive your breakthrough. Ha ye ko to bredi ta. Lord, I give you praise. I give you glory, Spirit of the living God. You are the Spirit of truth and the revealer of the truth. You have searched out the deep things in the heart of God. Tonight you are here to make intercession for us. Holy Spirit, you are the one that we need. I give you my heart and I give you my mouth. Lord, use tonight. Niko Rabba. Let your word be mixed with faith in the heart of your people. Then give us the abundant grace to pray tonight. Enable us. Let your fire fall upon us. Let your anointing come upon us. Let your mercy flow towards us. You are so good. You are so kind. I thank you, Father. At the end of tonight, let everyone under the sound of my voice and those that will listen to this message and this prayer session tonight on YouTube, on Facebook, on Periscope, on the internet, oh Lord, the same power and anointing here, let it also reach out to those that will listen to this message in the name of Jesus. I give you all the glory, oh God. In Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Glory, hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Only three people are answering. You know, they used to sing this song, if you're happy, let amen.
Amen.
If you're happy, let me know. Say amen.
Amen.
If you're happy, let me know. And you really want to show. If you're happy, let me see. Let me hear. Say amen.
Amen.
If you're happy, let me hear. Say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
If you're happy, let me hear you say hallelujah. You are happy, let me know. And you really want to show. If you are happy, let me hear you say, praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Amen. Glory. Glory, glory. Hallelujah. Glory, glory. Praise the Lord. Anyway, tonight, I have every reason to praise the Lord, and you too, you have every reason to praise the Lord. Some people are supposed to be in the presence of God right now, the first Friday of the month, and this will be the last Friday in 2016. Some are in clubhouses now, some are on their job. Some are sleeping, some are watching TV, some are in movie theater. But you have chosen the best place to be tonight. Amen. To God be the glory. I want to thank God for, you know, the visionaire of Wind and Fire, Pastor Mike and Pastor Dr. Mrs. Aderonke Modi. So I want to thank the assembly pastor, Pastor Kwesi, and Pastor Mrs. Kwesi. Hallelujah. for the opportunity I'm given once again to stand here and bring the word of God. Glory, hallelujah, amen. The Bible says we should give honor to whom honor is due. November 16, 1991, you all should know it now. The Lord said to me, I have called you to minister to people with chronic problems. The Lord said to me, I've called you also to take my word, this written word, with power to the troubled and afflicted souls, troubled homes, widows, orphans, the poor and the needy. This is the mandate of God upon my life. Amen. And there is no impossibility with our God. No problem is greater and bigger than God. Amen. It depends on how you view your problem, and it depends on your knowledge of who God is. Most people know God through the knowledge of others, but God desires that you know Him personally. He is your Father. He wants you to, you know, have one-on-one relationship with Him. You know, thank God for Jesus. He's calling us into what? Relationship. Thank God for coming to church. But you keep coming, you don't bring your friend, you don't bring your schoolmate, you don't bring your workmate. If you are being blessed, why do you keep coming alone? If all of you tonight, if you have invited one person, you know that person will be blessed and God will also reward you. Amen. Hallelujah. Tonight we have come to pray, but I have to bring the word of God before we pray, because we have to pray with understanding. When we pray with understanding, which is praying from the word of God, then we have assurance, because God keeps His own word. Amen. So the title of the message tonight is Warfare Through Praise. What do I say? Amen. You know, we used to pray. But tonight we're going to see. When God said tonight, I said, Lord, what do you want? What is the scripture? Hallelujah. And He said to me, 2 Chronicles chapter 1, chapter 20. Can we open our Bible to 2 Chronicles chapter 20? We're going to read from verse 1 through verse 30. In the word of God there is power. You know, this is not Sunday worship, this is prayer meeting. In the name of Jesus, every name must bow. Hallelujah. Sing it like your meaning. In the name of Jesus, every name must bow. The power of God is in His word. 2 Chronicles chapter 20, let's look at it. And as we go, we may pause, sing, or pray. Amen. Till we get to verse 30. 2 Chronicles chapter 20, verse 1. It came to pass after this also. You know, it came to pass after this also. It means some things have been going on before this chapter 20. And it says, it came to pass after this also. We don't have the time to go to chapter 19. Because chapter 20 is a continuation of chapter 19. It came to pass after this also that the children of Moab and the children of Ammon, and with them other beside the Ammonites, came against Jehoshaphat to battle. Praise the Lord. Ami, you are not looking for trouble. But trouble come to knock at your door. You know, some people are so careless in their Christian life. They are always on the defensive. I'm not troubling anybody. I don't have a problem. Nobody can do me anything. You deceive yourself. If you're not doing people evil, there are people cooking evil against you that you are not aware of. Look at it. Came to pass, I'm going to repeat it again, after this also, that the children of Moab and the children of Ammon, and with them under other beside the Ammonites, came against Jehoshaphat to battle. Hey, King Jehoshaphat. The children of Moab, that is one country. All the armies of the country of Moab, all the armies of the countries of Ammon, and if you go down, all the armies of the country of Mount Seir came to battle against Jehoshaphat, against the king of Judah. And Judah is the least in Israel. Judah is the least. Only two tribes make up Judah. Judah and Benjamin. They didn't go to the ten tribes that made up the Israel now. They came to three countries and the army. They gathered, fortified themselves to come and battle against Judah. Judah is so few compared to the remaining 10 tribes. Can three countries, the army of 10 countries, come to look for someone? They already sized them up that they know their military strength. Let's just go and override them and finish them and take over their land. Verse 2. Then there came some that told Jehoshaphat, saying, there coming a great multitude against thee from beyond the sea on this side Syria. And behold, they be in Hazazotoma, which is Engedi. Verse 3. And Jehoshaphat feared. He was afraid. Hey! How are we going to survive? Who is going to help us? The three nations with all their military force, great multitude. It won't even take them 3 hours before they will clear off Judah. They were in agreement. They were united, which means they will be unstoppable, because where there is unity, oneness, one accord, no division, they are unstoppable. Only God can stop them. As it was in Genesis 11, the Babel, when they were building the tower, God himself said, nobody can stop them. They will build this tower to meet him in heaven, except he will need to go there and stop them. And he did. This is negative unity. And it will produce result if God does not intervene. And so Jehoshaphat feared and said, what did he do? He set himself to seek the Lord and proclaimed a fast throughout all Judah. You know, let me ask you, when sudden problem arises, What do you do? What is the first thing that comes to your mind? Many of us, we think of, who am I going to call that will help me? Many of us will say, oh, let me run to my family. Oh, let me call my friends. Let me run to my neighbor. But if God is not helping human beings you are running to, they have no help to render you. But this is the first lesson we should learn about King Jehoshaphat. Even though he was afraid, he was quaking. But what did he, the Bible say? He set himself. Which means he was determined right then inside of him. He made a resolute decision that the only way out of this issue is to run to God. He set himself. He made up his mind. He was determined to consult no other person but God Almighty. After he had made up his mind, then the next thing he did was to proclaim a fast throughout Judah. That is national fasting. It's like, okay, this is Rochester, Minnesota. Maybe the mayor will now declare, well, everybody living in Rochester, you have to fast. The only way we go into 2017, we have to fast so that the state, you know, can give us resources to run the city. You know what I'm giving an example now. Amen. But look at verse 4. And Judah gathered themselves together. They listened to their king. Because all the people in Judah now, they are also afraid. It's like, oh, they already finished. So when their king said, everybody, I declare fasting, including children, toddler, whatever, sucking babies, no more food. We have to cry unto God. And what happened? If we were to be here in America, that we don't play with our stomach. You get out of bed, you won't say Jesus good morning. You run into the kitchen, you open the fridge, you're looking for what to put in your stomach. The one you ate before you slept had not digested. But your stomach is crying. Not that you are hungry. But because you're already used to putting food in your mouth, you program your system that once you jump out of bed, the next thing, coffee, food, whatever. But when the king said, trouble has come, we were not preparing for what has come to our door. So what are we going to, why are we going to escape? Get out of this problem. We all have to put down our plates fast. Verse 4, and they all gathered together to ask help of the Lord. Even out of all the cities of Judah, they came to seek the Lord. One thing I have discovered in my 24 years of preaching this gospel all over is that it's problem that always make people to run to God. There are so many people that if they don't have problem, when they talk about God, I have no time. God, oh no. But when problem comes that they no way out, that's when they will remember, oh God. All of them, they agree and they came to see God. Verse 5, and Jehoshaphat stood in the congregation of Judah and Jerusalem in the house of the Lord before the new court. And what did he say to God? This is to also help us when we start to pray. What do you say to God? Let's look at it. What he said to God in verse 6. and said, O Lord God of our fathers, art not thou God in heaven, and ruleth not thou over all the kingdoms of the heathen? And in thy hand is there not power and might, so that none is able to withstand thee? Verse 7. Art not thou a God who did drive out the inhabitants of this land before your people Israel, and gave it to the seed of Abraham thy friend forever? And they dwell therein, and have built thee a sanctuary therein for thy name, saying, if when evil come upon us as a sword, judgment or pestilence or famine, we stand before this house and in thy presence, for thy name is in this house, and cry unto thee in our affliction, then thou wilt hear and help. Verse 10. And now, behold, the children of Ammon and Moab and Mount Seir, whom thou wilt not let Israel invade when they came out of the land of Egypt, but they turn from them and destroy them not. Behold, I say how they reward us, to come to cast us out of thy possession, which thou hast given us to inherit. O our God, wilt thou not judge them? For we have no might against this great company that cometh against us. Neither know we what to do, but our eyes are upon thee. See his approach to God. He did not approach God with the fear already in his heart. He reminded God how they got, their forefathers got into the land of Canaan, their land of inheritance. He said to God, Lord, are you not the one, you know, who has power and might? What was he saying? He said, Lord, this has come with their military forces and their weapons of war, you know, great multitude. But what was he saying? Yes, it's a fact that they have military strength, three countries coming together. He said, but oh Lord God, are you not the one who is powerful and mighty? What was he saying? Can their own military strength, oh God, be compared unto you, the God of power and might? Are you not the one who rules? Are you not the one who rules in the kingdom of unbelievers, the hidden unbelievers, those that do not know you? Are you not the one that is ruling in heaven and on the earth? What was he saying? Lord, you are in charge, you are in control. I will not be moved right now by what my eyes are seeing, but I want to, Lord, recognize, and I want to acknowledge your mightiness. The reason why people get depressed and discouraged when trouble comes is because all their focus is onto the problem and the source of the problem. When you shift your gaze from God Almighty, who has the power to do all things, the enemy will have their way. See how he was dialoguing with God, because prayer is what is dialogue. He reminded God that nobody can stand against God. He reminded God about the prayer of King Solomon when he dedicated the temple. That was what he said, that in this your house, your name is here. It was King Solomon that said, if when enemy come And in this place, we lift up our eyes. We call upon you when affliction comes, when there is trouble. Lord, hear from heaven. That was what Jehoshaphat the king was reminding God. And if he had not been reading the word of God, when trouble come, would he have been able to quote and rehearse the prayer of King Solomon into the ears of God? So that is why we need to be lovers of our Bible. You know, again, in stating his case, Holy Spirit is our advocate, which means he's our, you know, he's our attorney, our defense lawyer. So you have to present your case before God when trouble comes. You have to present your case so God can see the reason why he should help you. He now reminded God again in verse 10. He said, Lord, when the children of Israel came out of Egypt, they were supposed to pass through the land of Moab. Moab said no. They said, we're not going to enter through your cities, we're going to go through your highway, but if we drink from your well, your water, or the animal, we will pay you. They said, no, you won't pass through our borders. They came to the border of the Edomite, because the Edomite, the Mount Seir, are the descendants of Esau. Those one also say, no, we won't let you pass through our land. That was why they have to go again round through the Red Sea. A longer journey. God said no, because they are families. You know why? These Moabites and Ammonites, they are the descendants of Lot. And Lot was Abraham's nephew. Mount Seir is the descendant of Esau, Jacob's twin brother. So what are we seeing here? It's a family issue. Hello? That God said, don't take, I have not given you part of their land. You pass through them to get your own land I have prepared for you. Just for them to pass through, they refuse. The Edomite, Mount Seir, they were even killing them. When the enemy came to fight them, they joined the enemy. So he was reminding God, Lord, you did not allow us to destroy or harm them. But now they have come. They are paying us evil for good our forefathers did to them. They are come to pay us evil for good. When you say destroy all the country, you know, in Canaan land, you did not allow us, you spared them. Because God still know that, you know, they all came from the same root. Why would they now come? Three countries that from generation past, they are one family, came to destroy Judah. He reminded God about that. When you go before God, how do you present your prayer? You don't just jump back up, You have to approach God with understanding. Argue your case so that God can help you. Now, let's continue verse 14 and 15. Then upon Jehaziel, you know, if you look at verse 11, behold, I say how they reward us. You know, verse 12, O God, we thou not judge them, for we have no might against this great company that come against us. Neither know we what to do, but our eyes are upon thee. And all Judah stood before the Lord with their little ones, their wives, and their children. Then upon Jehaziel, the son of Zechariah, the son of Benaiah, the son of Jair, the son of Mataniah, a Levite of the sons of Asaph, came the Spirit of the Lord in the midst of the congregation. And he said, hearken ye all Judah, and ye inhabitants of Jerusalem, And thou, King Jehoshaphat, thus saith the Lord unto you, be not afraid nor dismayed by reason of this great multitude, for the battle is not yours, but God's. And now look at, if you look at that, what did God say? The battle is not war. Now, prayer is dialogue. King Jehoshaphat had been talking to God. Then he came, when he stopped speaking, God now, you know, through the power of the Holy Spirit, came upon Jehaziel and he started to prophesy. This is what God is saying. And what did God say to God? God already know that all of the king and everybody, they were afraid. And what was the first thing the Lord God said? Be not afraid. Some people are already afraid of 2017. Will I make it? What will happen to me? The same way God is telling you tonight, be not afraid. You know why? Because God already knows how everything will end. They have not got to the battlefront. But the God they sought his face with fasting had already seen the end of the battle. Are you getting it? In the same way, God had already 2017 from January to December 2017, as we are here tonight, God already seen it all. Hello? Hallelujah! So, be not afraid, nor what dismayed. Do not worry because of their size or their military weapons or their abilities to fight war. Don't let that move you. He said, the battle is not yours, but God's. We have problem, when we carry that problem as is my problem, then God is outside, then you're gonna carry on for long, because they didn't have the stamina, the abilities to face their enemies. So they turn to God, who have power and might to deal with the enemy. So whatever may be your problem, that you nurse like a baby, keep nursing it until the day you turn it to the Lord. That is when and then we come to that problem. Are you getting what I'm saying? So, God, he loves us. But even we see the Lord Jesus Christ, when blind Bartimaeus was crying, have mercy, son of David. You know, Jesus did as if he didn't hear him, right? But when he persisted in calling for Jesus' help, Jesus now stood still. They said, he's calling you. He ran towards Jesus. Even though Jesus knew he was blind, he asked him, what will you have me do? Hello? He has to use his own mouth to say that I may do what? Receive my sight. Some of us Christians will say, God knows what I'm going through. If he really cares, he would have helped me. And you have to tell God what you want. What if God intervened, then you get angry? Some people enjoy their problem. You know why? If solution comes, they will lose their friends. Some people is friends. They can't part way with their friends. Some, they can't leave their family. No. So, your problem will remain. Because if God intervene without you releasing and allowing God to do it his own way, you may be angry. At the end of, and still complain. Hey, yeah, I need the blessing, but now, now. I miss everybody. The moment you still wrap yourself around your family, how will God help you? Because for Abraham, if he had remained in his country, he would not have inherited the promised land. God had to separate him from his father's house and took him from among not only his family, the whole country. Send him far, far away. And that far away is the blessing, his blessings, and the blessings of his generation yet unborn were waiting in that far. If he had remained in his country, we won't hear about Abraham. But God would have raised somebody else. Are you getting what I'm saying? That promised land, God would have still given up, God would have still given it to somebody else. If Abraham had refused to leave his father's house and his family. Because whatever God wants to do, he will still do it. Whether you yield or not, God will never lack any human being to use for his own purpose. So, let's continue. And what did God do there? You see that verse 4, 14 and 15 is prophecy. God, when we pray, he speaks back to us. Prayer is not monologue. Prayer is dialogue. You are communicating with the Almighty God. But most of the time, when we are praying, your mind is not at rest. Your mind is not focused. You just want the prayer to end. And the moment, you just step away from where you are praying. Most of the time, people don't give God, time to speak back to them. He said, be still and know that I am God. I'll be exalted in the earth. So after you finish praying, you have to wait. Be still inside of you. Don't rush out from the presence of God when you are praying. If you don't have time to wait, then don't pray. And make it look as if God doesn't hear and he doesn't answer prayer. He does. And if you are sweating him, he will speak into your ears like you will hear the way. No, most of the time God speaks in a still small voice. It will drop something in your heart. But some people will think, oh, that's my thinking. No, if you have been praying and you just quiet something drop into you that you were not even thinking about, that is God. Sometimes he can tell you, wait. Sometimes he can tell you, pray more. Sometimes he cannot give you scripture. Pray like this. Now we will see. In the same way, still the same pattern I want to show you. They all came together, the whole Judah. Everybody. And before everybody, King spoke to God. And God responded instantly through Jahaziel in a prophecy. In that prophecy, what happened? God, first of all, calm them down. Do not be afraid. Do not be dismayed, right? The battle is not yours. What was God doing? God was lifting the burden of heaviness, that hopelessness. The first one has to be, do not be afraid. Do not be dismayed. The battle is not yours. That has taken away all the weight, all the burden, all the fear, all the worry and anxiety. God first of all lifted that from the first thing he said. In the same way, when you pray, God will give you assurance. If he tell you wait, what is he trying to tell you? Wait means don't do anything. I've heard you. If he say wait, you wait. In the position of waiting, you praise him. Till he comes to you again to give you. Now, he will speak. And now let's speak. Look at verse 16. Hallelujah. Verse 16. Tomorrow, go ye down against them. Behold, they come up by the cliff of Ziz, and you shall find them at the end of the brook, before the wilderness of Jeruel. When we pray, God will speak. Here he has spoken, And then he's still talking, and in his talking in verse 16, he's now giving instruction and what? Direction. Hello? He told them, you will not fight in this battle. I've taken over the battle. But he still wanted them to go war, to move forward and proceed to the battle front. And specifically, he said, tomorrow. The reason why we don't feel fulfilled when we pray is because we don't follow God. These are the way and manner God answer prayer. Before you will see manifestation of what you are asking for, he will speak to you. He will also give you instruction of what to do for you to receive answer to what? To your prayers. Still in the business of answering prayers. The Lord Jesus said in Matthew chapter 7 verse 7, ask and you shall receive, seek you will find. Here you see they sought God and they found God. Knock and the door shall be open. And that was what happened here to them. God gave them instruction. Say, tomorrow, what did he say? Go down. Go down against them. And God didn't know exact points where they are. But hear God. God said to them, behold, they come up by the cliff of Ziz. Many of us talk to God as if he does not see, does not have knowledge. God told them, the enemy, they are coming up by the cliff of Ziz. But you go down. Look at that. Your enemy are coming from the valley up. You are on top. They are coming up to meet you, but you go down to meet them. God didn't say, you stay where you are, let them come and meet you inside your city. Are you getting what I'm saying? Because they are marching, they are coming. Their desire is to come and enter the land of Judah, enter their cities and all the cities. But God said to me, to them, you go tomorrow. Before they get to you, you get to them. They are coming up, but you go down. This is the point and location they are right now. And that's where I want you to meet them. See, God is a God of specification and location. He will give you instruction and direction. And God said, you shall find them at the end of the brook before the wilderness. This God is an excellent God. Can I hear an amen? You know, they say it's omniscience God. He knows all things. And he can also do all things. Why are we seeing him doing all things for us? It's because we have not been looking for him the way he expects us to look for him. So we can always get his help. Hallelujah. Verse 17, he said, you shall need. See it again. What he said in verse 15 is saying in verse 17 again, you shall not need to fight in this battle. That's the second time he's assuring them. I want you to go and meet them, but you will not fight. Set yourself, stand still, and see the salvation of the Lord with you. The same thing God said to Moses at the mouth of the Red Sea, when the Egyptian army pursued them, and they looked back, ha, to their left mountain, right mountain, before them the Red Sea, they looked back, Egyptian army, they were crying, God said, tell them to move forward. He said, for the Egyptian you have seen today, you will see them no more. For the Lord shall fight for you, and you shall hold your peace. Exodus 14, verse 13 and 14. Hallelujah. The same thing God was saying here. You shall not need to fight in this battle. What is the battle that you've been fighting? You have no victory. Why not release that battle to God tonight? Ask him. Give it to him. Ask for his help. God is ever ready to help us. You just have to assess that help is always the issue. Now, let's look at, that was verse 17, O Judah and Jerusalem, fear not, nor be dismayed. You see it again. Tomorrow he's repeating it. Go out against them, for the Lord will be with you. How many of us agree that even as you are seated right now, the Lord is with you? And if you know it, then your amen will be louder. Are you afraid to say it? Or you are not sure that the Lord is with you? He is with you. And look at verse 18. And Jehoshaphat bowed his head with his face to the ground, and all Judah and the inhabitants of Jerusalem fell before the Lord, worshiping the Lord. See, the title of this message is Warfare Through Praise. What did they do? Their king set the pace. When he received the word of the Lord and instruction, he knew that it's done. All fear gone. He prostrated before the subjects. And when they saw king lie on his face, everybody lay on the face. I mean, how glorious that worship would have been. They have not gotten to the battlefront, but they believe that word that came from God. They worship the word of God. If we worship the word of God, we will see God in action. Many of us, you want to see what you are asking for before you will praise him. Look, if what you already see, you don't have to believe for it. Are you getting it? You don't believe for what you have. Faith is the substance of things you hope for, the evidence of what you have not seen. So, the Lord Jesus said in John chapter 20 to Thomas, say, blessed are they that believe when they have not seen. So, the reason why prayers are not answered is that, okay, when I got that letter of my new job, and then I will worship God. And when I pass that exam, when I buy a new house. No. Start praising him now. It is because it is your praise that will bring that to pass. So the king set the pace, and everybody fell down worshiping God in the church. You know, and when praise and worship is going on, some people, they will just stand. See a whole king, just like in David too. Hallelujah. So can you stand and walk about instead of you? Because I want you to listen and hear. We'll be praying shortly. Verse 19, and the Levites of the children of the Kohathites and of the children of the Kohites stood up to praise the Lord God of Israel with a loud voice on high. Now the choir now took their stand. When the king set the pace without music, the king, you know, prostrated, was worshiping God, rolling on the floor, others joined. The choir took their stand and they begin to praise. They started praising the Lord God of Israel with a loud voice on high. So shouting is allowed in the presence of God. Dancing is allowed. Amen. Jumping is allowed. And they rose early in the morning and went forth into the wilderness of Tekoa. And as they went forth, Jehoshaphat stood and said, hear me, O Judah, and you inhabitant of Jerusalem. Believe in the Lord your God, so shall you be established. Believe his prophet, so shall you prosper. Now, how many of us want to be established? Huh? Okay. You have to believe God. to be established is simple. Believe God. Believe His power. Believe His greatness. Believe in His mightiness. Believe in His ability and capabilities to do all things. Hello. Hallelujah. So, and if you want to prosper, what do you want to do? What must you do? Believe in the prophets of God. Why? Because of the word of God that God always releases through the prophets and the prophetess. The true prophets and prophetess. If you believe in the word they say, you will prosper. Amen. So, and when they are consulted with the people, again, look at it. Warfare through praise, verse 21. And when they are consulted with the people, he appointed singers unto the Lord, and that should praise the beauty of holiness. As they went out before the army, and to say, praise the Lord, for his mercy endures forever. And when they began to sing and to praise, the Lord set ambushments against the children of Ammon, Moab, and Mount Seir, which were come against Judah, and they were smitten. For the children of Ammon and Moab stood up against the inhabitants of Mount Seir, utterly to slay and destroy them. And when they had made an end of the inhabitants of Seir, everyone helped to destroy one another. Look at that. Moab and Ammonites, they had no. They came out of Lot. You know? Lot had two daughters. When they came out of Sodom and Gomorrah, when the Lord sent two angels to go and rescue Lot, the wife and the two daughters, they were given warning not to look back. The angels held them by the hand. As they were going, Lot's wife looked back. And she became a pillar of salt till tomorrow. Amen. And so Lot was left with the two daughters that didn't look back. So when they got to where they were supposed to run to for safety, they now discover, we didn't see mommy again. Mommy, Mrs. Lot, has turned to pillar of salt. So, after everything they settled, there was no man in sight. So, Lot pregnated the first daughter and the second daughter. The first one gave birth to Moab. The second daughter gave birth to Ammon. So, what are we saying? Are they not the children of the same father? They are. See, when they join force with Mount Seir, see what happened here? When God set an ambushment, you know, God told Judah, you will not have to fight the battles of the Lord. So when God began to fight for them before they get to see them face to face now, Moab and Ammonite, they destroyed Mount Seir. So after they finished that, Moab and Ammonite now, they started to fight themselves. And they also did what? Everyone helped to destroy another. No one escaped. When God fights for your battles, your enemy, none of them will escape. So, 24, and when Judah came towards the watchtower in the wilderness, they looked into the multitude, and behold, they were dead bodies falling to the earth, and none escaped. Ha, cha-cha. And when Jehoshaphat and his people came to take away the spoil of them, they found among them in abundance both riches with the dead bodies and precious jewels, which they stripped them off from themselves, more than they could carry away. And they were 3 days in gathering of the spoil. It was so much. Ha. You see, when God fight for you, Judah was supposed to be destroyed. But now, because they relied on God, they depended on God, they did not trust in their own abilities or look for human help or run to Assyria or Philistine to come and help them, But when they trusted and depended only on God's power and might, see what happened. All their enemies, those great multitude, they were all destroyed. Before they got to see them face to face, they met with their bodies. And all these three countries, they came with riches. They came with jewelries, jewels, gold, silver, ornaments, precious ones. You know what I'm saying? Costly pearls they came with. I mean, you're going to fight war. You carrying every money. Will you be spending money in the wilderness? But you know what? God allowed them to do that, so that everything they brought with them can be transferred to Judah. So what am I saying? At the end of it all, Judah get more rich. Judah was more richer. Judah prospered as a result of those three countries coming to fight them. So if Mount Seir, Ammonites, and Moab had known that they're going to be defeated and defeated, they wouldn't have even tried what they tried. But at the end of it, they had a great loss, because none of them returned home. And everything was turned over to Judah. Are you getting it? Oh, let's go and finish them. They size them up. But at the end of it, all the people they looked down upon sized them up as the one that now took over all their possessions. And then it took Judah 3 days' journey to carry all this good stuff. They were going first day, go back, second day, 3 days. They keep carrying blessing. Ha! I mean, it's for example, we are in America. Is somebody waking up, you are afraid of, you know, losing everything you have, rather than losing your life and all your stuff, suddenly you stumbling into wealth, you become billionaire, suddenly. You know, 2 days ago, you were crying, fear, their enemy has come. But today, you keep carrying. As you keep, you go back again. See much to carry. Cha! What a mighty God we serve! What a mighty God we serve! Heaven and earth adore Him. Angels bow before Him. What a mighty God we serve. Look at what is it you are afraid of? Why not turn it over to the Lord like King Jehoshaphat did? Wow. Then verse 26, on the fourth day they assembled themselves in the valley of Berecha. For there they blessed the Lord. Therefore the name of the same place was called the Valley of Berecha unto this day. Look at what they did. They have the spirit of appreciation and gratitude. After they have carried all the stuff, all the riches, all the wealth, all the precious jewelries, and nothing to carry again, they set one day, the fourth day, they went back. You know, God told them, you will meet them in the valley, go down. They went back to that valley to do what? To praise God. Hello? Because they started to go to the battlefront with praise. And after God gave them victory, they went back to that battlefront to praise God. Many of us, once God had answered us, our desires are met, we are fulfilled, that's it. We start praising Him. You just praise Him. Maybe one that moment, after that you don't praise Him again. They went back. They set one day apart to go and bless God in that place where God defeated their enemy. Are you getting what I'm saying? Hallelujah. Okay. Now, then, verse 27, then they return every man of Judah and Jerusalem and Jehoshaphat in the forefront of them to go again to Jerusalem with joy, for the Lord had made them to rejoice over their enemies. What are we learning from here? The fourth day, they went to the scene of the battle to worship and praise God. After that, they all again gathered, went back to Jerusalem. You know, they came from different cities when they had the news of the enemies coming. Now, after they got their victory and they got all the riches and wealth, they all left all their different cities again to go to Jerusalem in the same house of God where they asked for God's help. With joy and rejoicing, because the Lord had made them to do what? Rejoice over their enemies. God gave them victory. That is what God is expecting from us. The heart of gratitude, appreciation. Hello? It's not a right. Sometimes when we are blessed, some people will take it for granted. It's my right now if you give me and so what? There's no gratitude in that. If somebody bless you, God touch their heart, you worship God greatly, and you thank whoever God has used. But most of the appreciation should go to God, because it's from Him all blessings flow. Nothing we receive except is given from heaven above. They recognize and acknowledge that God answered their prayers. He fought for them. As God promised, God cannot lie. Said they would not have to fight in that battle. And they didn't lift a finger. They didn't use any weapon against their enemies. God finished all their enemies. In the same way, God will finish all your enemies. If you will have the heart of gratitude to praise Him. Amen. Now, verse 28. And they came to Jerusalem with psalteries and harp and trumpet unto the house of the Lord. Are you getting what I'm saying? When next was it that you came to this church, you have thanksgiving, and you call all your friends to follow you? God has done something. No, you come here, have testimony. No. If God has done something good for you, you have to tell others. Join me to thank God. If you don't want to tell them the details of what the Lord has done, that's okay. But, let people accompany you to join you to praise Him. God, that will move God. That you appreciate what He has done, that you even invite others to join you to praise Him. Are you getting what I'm saying? Ha, Lord help us. See, are we learning something tonight? Look at verse 29. And the fear of God was on all the kingdoms of those countries when they had heard that the Lord fought against the enemies of Israel. Amen. The other countries, like the Philistines, they were not afraid. God finished all the enemies again. Like the way He sang all the Egyptian army and their horses and chariots in the Red Sea. God again fought for them this time. Everybody, no one escaped. So what happened? As a result of that, what happened? Verse 30, which is our last verse. So the realm of Jehoshaphat was quiet, for his God gave him rest round about. What am I saying? It's good to have enemy. You know why? when the enemy come, then they will know that I'm serving the Almighty God. Are you getting it? If Moab, Ammonite, and Amaziah did not come to fight against Judah, the other surrounding countries, they will not be afraid of the God of Israel. Are you getting what I'm saying? So, me, I love it. Fight, be fighting me. When my God arise, those that, amen. What are we saying tonight? Our God is a man of war, and the Lord of hosts is his name. We see it displayed here. But tonight, Jehoshaphat, the king, you know, gather all the people in his land to see God's face at one time. And because God saw their willingness and their readiness for God to intervene for them, God did not fail them. They were not put to shame. Their prayers and fasting were not in vain. How many times have we been fasting and praying, and yet we are still waiting for answers? Only one time they did all that. Because they were united in their prayers. They were of one voice. They have only one request, not different requests. Their hearts were united. Their mind was one. They were in one accord. They got the attention of God. How about you tonight? Hallelujah. No, now, can we get up now? We're going to prayer session now. Glory, hallelujah. If you have been blessed, can you praise the Lord? Are you so tired? Amen. Are you tired tonight? Don't be tired, though. Because we are here to pray. Hallelujah. Well, I know we really have learned from the way and manner the people of Judah and their kings saw the face of the Lord, and he did answer them. Glory, hallelujah. Amen. God is still in the business of answering prayer. He wants to show himself strong on our behalf. Can we begin to praise God tonight? Let's begin to thank God. Open your mouth. I want you to open your mouth. Open your mouth and talk to God tonight. Thank him from January to December 3rd. Give him praise. From those, for his goodness, for his faithfulness, thank him for his protection, for strength. You have a job, you have good health, sound mind, you are doing well in college, in school. Bless his holy name. Thank him. Don't take God for granted tonight. Don't take his mercy, his grace for granted. Lord, I give you praise. Open your mouth and begin to bless him. Lord, I appreciate you, your goodness, your kindness, your mercy, O God, unto me and my family. Thank him tonight for your family. He has watched over you from January 1st to this moment. God is faithful, he's worthy, and worthy to be praised. The Lord is worthy and worthy to be praised. He is worthy and worthy to be praised. The Lord is worthy and worthy to be praised. He is worthy and worthy to be praised. He deserves all the glory. He deserves all honor. He deserves all adoration. He deserves our gratitude. Hallelujah, Lord, I bless you, God. I'm most grateful, O Lord. I thank you and I bless your holy name because of who you are. You know, thank him tonight. Thank him from the bottom of your heart, from the core of your being. Bless his holy name tonight. 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 Even if God has not done anything for you this year, you are alive, you are well. Bless his holy name tonight. Give him all the glory. Only the living and the living. We thank him. Thank him tonight. His ears are open to hear us tonight. Let him hear your voice. And let your heart be connected with your mouth tonight. That as you are expressing your praises and adoration, there is connection between your heart and your mouth. He collected from the depth of your heart, from the bottom of your soul. Magnify the Lord because he's good. All the time, God is good. Every moment, every second, God is good. You are alive, you are well. You have roof over your head. You have shelter. There are some people that are homeless in the cold right now that don't have the warmth, the comfort you have. And then they have not given up on God. Bless his holy name tonight. God is worthy. Whatever may be your situation, God is more than able. He is the Lord God of might and power. He will do it for you. Your own may not be physical battle. It could be battle of the mind. It could be battle of your soul. It could be battle against your health. It could be your financial battles. It could be failure in the area of academic works. It could be whatever the challenge may be. It could be your family. Thank him tonight. Focus as you praise him tonight. Focus your mind and praise him tonight. Because you are alive. Because you have eyes that can see. You have ears that hear. Your heart is working. Your kidneys are working. Bless his holy name tonight. You can walk. You have hands, you can move. Your ears can hear. Your eyes see. Why not praise him tonight? Oh, glory, hallelujah. Father, I thank you. I'm most grateful, oh God, for all you have done for me, even and my family, from January the 1st to December 3rd, 2016. Thank you, oh Lord. In Jesus' mighty name, we have given thanks. Now please speak your Bible. One of praising from Psalm 5. And we want to read it very fast. Please take your Bible. Everybody, please take your Bible. Oh, it's on the screen. Pastor, we put it on the screen. Psalm 5. The entire Psalm 5. We're going to read it very fast to praise him. Glory, hallelujah. If you're ready, open your Bible. Hallelujah. Psalm 5. Everybody, you're going to read. Psalm 5. Amen. Give ear to my words, O Lord. Consider my meditation. Read it very fast. Hearken unto the voice of my cry, my King and my God. For unto thee will I pray. My voice shall you hear in the morning. O Lord, in the morning will I direct my prayer unto you and will look up. For you are not a God that has pleasure in wickedness, neither shall evil dwell with you. The foolish shall not stand in your side. You hate all workers of iniquity. You shall destroy them that speak lies. The Lord will abhor the bloody and deceitful man. But as for me, I will come into your house in the multitude of your mercy. In your fear will I worship towards your holy temple. Lead me, O Lord, in your righteousness because of my enemies. Make your way straight before my face, for there is no faithfulness in their mouth. Their inward part is very wickedness. Their throat is an open sepulchre. They flatter with their tongue. Read it very fast. Destroy them, O God. Let them fall by their own counsels. Cast them out in the multitude of their transgressions, for they have rebelled against them. But let all those that put their trust in thee rejoice. Let them ever shout for joy, because thou defends them. Let them also that love thy name be joyful indeed. For you, O Lord, will bless the righteous. With favor will you compass him as with a shield. In the name of God, the Father, God, the Son, God, the Holy Spirit, glory, hallelujah, glory, hallelujah, glory, glory, hallelujah, glory, hallelujah, glory, hallelujah. Use your mouth to say glory, hallelujah. Glory, hallelujah. Glory, hallelujah to the King of Kings. Glory, hallelujah to the Lord of Lords. Glory, hallelujah to the soon coming King. Glory, hallelujah to the Lord Jesus Christ, the one who was and is to come. Glory, hallelujah. To the bread of life, glory, hallelujah, to the light of the world, glory, hallelujah, to the almighty Savior, Redeemer, Keeper, Sustainer, glory, hallelujah. Glory, hallelujah, to the King of glory, strong and mighty in battle. Glory, hallelujah, to the ancient of this. Glory, hallelujah, to the mighty one of Israel, the holy one of Jacob, the I am that I am, the ancient of days, immortal God, invisible God. Glory, hallelujah, to the man of war, Lord God of hosts. Glory, hallelujah. Glory, hallelujah. Glory, hallelujah, to the merciful God. Glory, hallelujah. Glory, hallelujah, to the Lion of Judah. Glory, hallelujah, to the roots and the offspring of David, the bright and the morning star. Glory, hallelujah. Glory, hallelujah, to the Lord God, the I am that I am, the beginning and the end, the one who has the keys to hell and death in his hand. Glory, hallelujah. Glory, hallelujah, to the Almighty God, the Everlasting Father. Glory, hallelujah. Glory, hallelujah, to the wonderful Counselor, the Prince of Peace. Glory, hallelujah. Ah, glory, hallelujah. Glory, hallelujah. Glory, hallelujah. Glory, hallelujah. Glory, hallelujah. Glory, hallelujah, to the I am that I am. Glory, hallelujah. Glory, hallelujah, to the very great King above all gods. Glory, hallelujah. To the one who sits on the circuit of the earth, the ancient of days, the master of the universe. Glory, hallelujah. To the righteous judge of the court of the universe. Glory, hallelujah. To the I am that I am. Glory, hallelujah. To the man of war. Glory, hallelujah. To the Jehovah Jireh, the Lord God that sees and provides. Glory, hallelujah, to Jehovah Rophika, the Almighty God, the healer. Glory, hallelujah. Glory, hallelujah, to the Almighty Creator. Glory, hallelujah. Glory, hallelujah. Glory, hallelujah. We are praising him with that Psalm 5. Now, glory, hallelujah, to his holy name. Glory, hallelujah, to his matchless name. Glory, hallelujah. Lord, we exalt you tonight. We exalt you tonight. We exalt you tonight. We exalt your holy name. We magnify you. You are greater than the greatest. You are mightier than the mightiest. You are stronger than the strongest. Glory, hallelujah. You are deeper than any deep. You are higher than any height. Glory, hallelujah, the one who brought water out of the rock. Glory, hallelujah, so the one who turns all the waters of the land of Egypt into blood. Glory, hallelujah, so the one who turned water into wine in Cana in Galilee. Glory, hallelujah. Glory, hallelujah, to the Lord God Most High, who brought money out of the mouth of the fish. Glory, hallelujah, to the Lord God, the Almighty Provider, who provided in the wilderness, who fed multitude with 5 loaves of bread and 2 fishes. Glory, hallelujah. Glory, hallelujah. To the mortal and invisible God, glory, hallelujah, to the immortality that dwells in unapproachable light, the sovereign King of kings and the Lord of lords, glory, hallelujah, to the King of kings, to the Lord of lords, to the God of gods, glory, hallelujah, glory, hallelujah, to the everlasting Father, glory, hallelujah, to the Father of all lights, glory, hallelujah, to the Lord God of the spirit of all flesh, glory, hallelujah, glory, hallelujah, glory, hallelujah, you are worthy of all our praise, O God, you are worthy, you are worthy, you are worthy, you are worthy to be praised, O God. Hallelujah, glory, hallelujah, say from the bottom of your heart, ayaya, glory, hallelujah, the first Friday of the month again will be in 2017. This is the last first Friday of the month this year. Glory, hallelujah. Glory, hallelujah. What fear through praise? What were they singing? For the Lord God is good and his mercy endures forever. For the Lord God is good and his mercy endures forever. For the Lord God of hosts is good and his mercy endures forever. For the Lord God of hosts is good and his mercy endures forever. For the man of war is good and his mercy endures forever. Ah, for the soon coming king is good and his mercy endures forever. For the Lord God of hosts, the man of war, is good unto me and his mercy endures forever. That was their song. And as they began to sing it, the Lord set ambushment against their enemies. And the Lord supervised the death of all the multitude that came against them. For the Lord God is good and his mercy endures forever. For the Lord God of hosts is good unto me and his mercy endures forever. For the Lord God of hosts is good unto me and his mercy endures forever. For the King of glory is good unto me and his mercy endures forever. From the ancient of days is good unto me and his mercy endures forever. The I am that I am is good unto me and his mercy endures forever. His mercy endures forever. Oh Lord God Most High, you are good unto me and my family, and your mercy endures forever. From January the 1st to December 3rd, 2016, for the Lord God Most High is good unto me and my family, and his mercy endures forever. Oh Lord God, you are good and your mercy endures forever. You are greater than the greatest. You are mightier than the mightiest. Oh, blessed be your holy name. The Lord God Most High, who sit on the circuits of the earth, you are good unto me and your mercy endures forever. The righteous judge of the court of universe, you are good unto me and my family, and your mercy endures forever. Jehovah Jireh, the Lord God that sees and provides, you are good unto me and my family, and your mercy endures forever. The Almighty Healer, who sent forth his word and heal us of all our diseases and deliver us from all destruction, he is good and his mercy endures forever. Almighty Sustainer, you are good and your mercy endures forever. Almighty Keeper, you are good unto me and your mercy endures forever. Almighty Redeemer, you are good unto me and your mercy endures forever. Hallelujah. 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 Say like you mean it tonight. That was their song as they marched, as they were marching towards the battlefront. Their song was, for the Lord God is good and his mercy endures forever. For the Lord God is good and his mercy endures forever. For the Lord God is good and his mercy endures forever. For the I am that I am is good and his mercy endures forever. 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 For the Lord God is good and his mercy endures forever. And his mercy endures forever. His mercy is from everlasting to everlasting. His mercy endures forever. Ah, glory, hallelujah. Glory, hallelujah. Glory, hallelujah. This is the way you are preparing yourself for 2017. This is the way to get prepared. For the Lord God is good, and His mercy endures forever. For the Lord God, the I am that I am, He is good, and His mercy endures forever. His mercy endures forever. His mercy endures forever. Brethren, listen. Because of you, this year, those whose business is those that are selling coffin and casket, they have not been consulted. Because the Lord God is good and His mercy endures forever. Why will you not praise Him? Do you know those that business is to sell casket and coffins, when they wake up in the morning, Lord, give them business. What are they praying for? Somebody should die so their business can prosper. And their prayer concerning you, concerning me, God had no answer. Is it not good? Is the Lord God not good? Praise Him. Do you know that pharmaceutical companies, those that are producing medication, every year they'll be declaring $1 billion profits? But if you don't go to the hospital, they are not getting your money. Even if you have insurance, you still pay, right? But you are healthy. Is the Lord God not good unto you? For the Lord God is good and His mercy endures forever. Blessed be your glorious name, O God. You are good unto us and your mercy endures forever. You are good unto us. Continuously, you are good. Thank you, Lord, for 2016. Thank you. Can you again say, Lord, thank you? Now say it louder. Let Him hear your voice. Let Him hear your voice. I appreciate the goodness of the Lord God Most High unto you and your family. The Lord has been good. He has been good. He has been kind. Hallelujah. Bless the Lord. Bless the Lord. No, if we were to be having party tonight, this place would be full. Bless His holy name. 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 We have received so much from the Lord this year. We need to give back through appreciation and gratitude. Warfare through praise. Bless His holy name. Bless His mighty name. Bless His holy name. He is so good, He's so kind. Hallelujah, glory, glory, hallelujah, glory, glory, hallelujah, glory, glory, hallelujah, glory, glory, hallelujah, glory, hallelujah, glory, glory, hallelujah, glory, glory, hallelujah, oh, glory, glory, hallelujah, 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 mahanderie, glory, hallelujah, glory, glory, hallelujah, glory, hallelujah, glory, glory, hallelujah, glory, glory, hallelujah, glory, glory, hallelujah, glory, glory, come on and bless his holy name. His word is worthy to be praised. His word is to be praised. His word is to be praised. And the Lord our God is worthy to be praised. He is worthy of all praise. Magnify the Lord. Magnify the Lord for the gifts of life. Glory, hallelujah. Warfare through praise. And to the brevity. Magnify the Lord, magnify his glorious name. Oh, ancient of days, I am that I am. Oh, the beginning and the ending, I am that I am. Everlasting Father, ancient of days, glory, hallelujah. The first and the last, he is the first and the last. He is the first and the last. For the Lord God is good and his mercy endures forever. For the Lord God is good and his mercy endures forever. For the Lord God is good and his mercy endures forever. For the Lord our God is good and his mercy endures forever. For the Lord God Most High is good and his mercy endures forever. Oh, for the Holy One, the mighty One of Jacob is good. The one who sits on the throne of grace in the heaven of the heavens. The one who makes the earth his footstool. For the Lord God Most High is good and his mercy endures forever. Oh Lord, you are good and your mercy endures forever. But the Lord God is good and your mercy endures. Walk around, walk around. But the Lord God is good and his mercy endures forever. Move about and move your feet. For the Lord God is good and his mercy endures forever. Warfare through praise. For the Lord God Most High is good and his mercy endures forever. But the Lord God is good and his mercy endures forever. But the Lord God of all grace is good and his mercy endures forever. He has done marvelously. God has done well. He has been good to us from January the 1st. Now to December 3rd, 2016, the Lord God Most High is good and his mercy endures forever. Oh, glory, glory, glory. Hallelujah, Lord. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Glory, 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 to the Lamb of God, to the Lamb of God, to the Lamb of God, glory, 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 oh, glory, 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 glory. Praise the Lord. Glory, glory. Glory, 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 glory. Glory, glory, glory. Gloria. Glory. 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 Glory! 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 Glory, glory! Hallelujah! Glory, glory, praise the Lord! Glory, glory! Hallelujah! Glory, glory, praise the Glory, glory! Glory, glory, praise the Lord. Glory, glory. Hallelujah. Glory, glory, praise the Lord. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Glory, praise the Lord. Glory, glory, hallelujah, hallelujah. Glory, glory, praise the Lord. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Glory, glory, praise the Lord. Okay, God is good. He has done me well. Rise up and praise the Lord. God is good. He has done me well, oh my soul. Rise up and praise the Lord. God is good. He has done me well, oh my soul. Rise up and praise the Lord. God is good. He has done me well, oh my soul. Rise up and praise the Lord. God is good. He has done me well, oh my soul. Rise up and praise the Lord. God is good, oh. Done me well, oh my soul. Rise up and praise the Lord. God is good. He has done me well, oh my soul. Rise up and praise the Lord. God is good, oh. He has done me well, oh my soul. Rise up and praise the Lord. Every living soul, praise the Lord. Every living soul, praise the Lord. I am a living soul, I'm a living soul, I praise the Lord. The most I reign, the most I reign, the most I reign in my life today. The most I reign, the most I reign, most I reign in my life today. I'm a living soul, my living soul, I praise the Lord. I'm a living soul, living soul, I praise the Lord. I am a living soul, a living soul, I praise the Lord. I'm a living soul, hey, yeah, yeah. The most I reign at, most I reign at, most I reign at in my life today. The most I reign at, most I reign at, most I reign at in my life today. The most I reign at, reign at, ha ha, I reign at. The most I reign at in my life today. The most I reign at, the most I reign at, the most I reign at in my life today. Hallelujah. Glory, hallelujah. I'm serving a God of miracles. Yes, I know. I'm serving the Lord of the God of miracles. Yes, I know. Hallelujah. I'm serving the God of miracles. I know. Yes, I know. I'm serving the God of miracles. Come and praise Him. Warfare through praise. I'm serving a God of miracles. I know, yes, yes, I know. I'm serving the God of miracles. I know, yes, I know. Hallelujah. I'm serving the God of, I know, yes, I know. I'm serving a God of miracles. I know. Yes, hallelujah. I'm serving a God of miracles. Come on now. Yes, I know. I am serving a God of miracles. I know. Yes, I know. Hallelujah. Ayaya. I know what fear true praise. Ejeri ororo I'm serving a God of miracles. I know. Yes, I. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. God of miracles. There's no possibility with our God. I'm serving a God of miracles. I know. Yes. Hallelujah. I am serving a God of miracles. I know. Yes, I know. I am serving a God of miracles. I know. Yes, I know. Praise the Lord. Imagine. Look at the scripture we have read for this prayer tonight. Judah were faced with sudden death and destruction. But because they serve a living God of miracle, they were supposed to die. Judah were supposed to what? They were supposed to walk over them, run them down, crush them, and forget about them. God, they serve a God of miracle. Those that meant to kill them, they were the one that died in place of Judah. Is that not the handwork of God of miracles? Somebody already, they have concluded before they left their three countries, Moab, Ammonai, and Masia, we're going to finish all the Judah. None of them will remain. What happened? It was none of the three countries, none of them remain. What they intended and meant for Judah, God turned it upon their head. The same way, whatever evil that the enemy meant for you and your family are waiting to manifest at the end of this month, the hand of God will put it on their head. As he did it for Judah. In Jesus, I'm serving a God. I know. I am serving a God. I know. Hallelujah. The God of miracles. I know. He's the same God. He does not sleep nor slumber. God of miracles. I know. What he did for Judah, he's doing it for you. Doing it for me and my family. I know. Yes, I know. I know. Yes, I know. Hallelujah. Praise him. What fear true praise? Miracle. No. Yes. Believe God. I'm serving. Believe God. Believe his prophetess. You will prosper. You will be established and prosper. I know. Yes. Hallelujah. Serving a God. I know. Yes. I know. Yes, I know. Hallelujah. Miracles. I know. I'm serving a God. Hallelujah. Praise him with the whole of your spirit. Yes, yes, hallelujah. Serving miracles. I know. Hallelujah. I'm serving a God. Come on, brother. Yes. Hallelujah. I know. Yes, I know. I'm serving a God. Miracle. I know. Yes. Hallelujah. God of possibilities is here. The God of possibilities. Miracle worker. He turned water into wine. He turned water It's your blood. Hallelujah. More miracles. I know. He brought money from the mouth of the fish. The Lord Jesus, the miracle worker. Hey, yeah, yeah. He raised the dead back to life. He cleansed the lepers. He made the lame to walk, the blind to see, the deaf to hear, the dumb to speak. I know. Hallelujah. Thank God. Yes. Receive the power of God now. Yes. Take the power of God. Praise God and be. Yes. Take the power of God now to praise Him. With the whole of your heart. Receive the power of God to work and establish a miracle for you. Take the power of God now that will establish your miracle as you praise Him. Take the power of God that creates miracles. Ayaya. My God. Yes, I know. I know. I'm serving miracles. Yes. God of possibilities is here. Miracle worker. The Son of the Living God. Jesus Christ. I know. Yes, I know. I'm serving the God of. I know. Yes. I know. Lord, I give you praise. I bless you tonight. Hallelujah. He's alive. Amen. He's alive. Jesus is alive. Forever he's alive. Amen. He's alive. He's alive. Jesus is alive. Forever he's alive. He's alive. He's alive. Jesus is alive. Forever he's alive. He's alive. He's alive. Jesus is alive. Forever he's alive. Let's say this one, then we continue with the prayer. Son of God, you will reign. You will reign forever. Ancient of days, you will reign. You will reign forever. Yonder I am, King of kings. You will reign. You will reign. I am the I am, Son of God, Lion of Judah. Soon coming King, King of glory, Lord of hosts, Man of war. Hey, hey. I am the Lion. Hey, yeah, yeah. I am the Lion. Hey, hey, hey. I am the Lion. I am the Lion. Hey, yeah, yeah, yeah. I am that I am. 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 Come on now. What fear to praise? I am that I am. King of glory.
Suka meke. Ejedi oror. I am the royal. Ejedi oror. Ancient of days. Ejedi oror. Son of God. Lion of Judah. Ejedi oror. I am the royal. Lamb of God. Bread of life. Light of the world. King of kings. King of kings. Lord of lords. Aha. Lord of hosts. Lord of hosts. So come again. Ancient of days. I am the Raya. I am the Raya. I am the Raya. I am the Raya. The Almighty God. Almighty God. Come on now. Mighty God. Bless him with the dance. Mighty God. Praise him with the dance, mighty God. Praise him in the dance. Praise him with the dance. Praise him in the dance. Come on now, move your feet. Mighty God. Hallelujah. Almighty God. Almighty God. Almighty God. Mighty God, Almighty God, Mighty God, Mighty God, Almighty God, Mighty God, Almighty God, soon coming King, Alpha and Omega. The first and last coming King. I am that I am. Redeemer Savior. Almighty Savior. Adonai. Elohim. Elion. Elion. Lion, Lion, the Most God, Adonai, King of Kings. You will reign forever. You will reign forever. You will reign. You will reign. Hallelujah. You will reign. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You will reign. Son of God. Son of God. Beat it fast. Son of God. Am that I am. King of glory, gentle days, soon coming King. We reign, you will reign forever. Hallelujah. You see? Warfare through praise. It's real praise. You see them in that Second Chronicle. After King Jehoshaphat worshiped God, what happened? When the Levites, that is the choir, said they stood up to praise the Lord God of Israel with a loud voice on high.
Hello. With a loud voice on high. When the choir took their stand, they praised God. They praised the Lord God of Israel with a loud voice on high. And it was there because God inhabits the praises of his people. His presence came down and finished all that battle. Hallelujah. Now we want to pray. Now begin to ask God. Say, Father God, I release.
I forgive
all my enemies that do not know what they are doing. In the name of Jesus. Precious Father, Holy Father, Righteous Father, I release and I forgive all my enemies that do not know what they are doing. In the name of Jesus. Father, forgive me all my sins. Lord, purge me, cleanse me from all unrighteousness. Have mercy on all my unrighteousness. Forgive my iniquities and my sins. Wash away with the blood of Jesus. Blot out all my transgressions and my sins with the blood of Jesus. And remember them no more. Help me, O God. Lord, I come unto you. I am helpless. Help me, O God. In Jesus' name. Let's welcome the presence of the Holy Spirit. Have me welcome the presence of the Holy Spirit tonight. Say, precious Holy Spirit, my intercessor, my helper, my advocate, my teacher, help me tonight. I want to pray, but I do not know exactly how to pray. I need your help. Holy Spirit, pray inside of me and pray through me. I give you my heart and I give you my mouth. Use to bring glory to the name of my Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Holy Spirit, help me not to grieve you tonight. Holy Spirit, crucify my flesh. Nail my flesh to the cross. I cannot nail myself. Therefore, I come to you, precious Holy Spirit. Nail my flesh to the cross tonight. Crucify my flesh. Put my flesh under. Silence the voice of my human flesh. In the name of Jesus. Holy Spirit, my body is your temple. Come and take your rightful place. Come and take your rightful position in me. Come and dwell in me and do your wonders in me and through me. In Jesus' holy name. Amen. Now we want to start the prayer now. Amen. Hallelujah. Say, O Lord God of hosts, I thank you for all the battles you have fought for me from January to December 2016. O Lord God of hosts, I thank you for all the battles you have fought for me from January to December 2016.
Oh Lord God of hosts, I thank you for all the battles you have fought for me from January to December 2016. In Jesus' name. Say, oh Lord God, grant me your abundance grace to turn to you for solution throughout 2017. In the name of Jesus. Oh Lord God, grant me your abundant grace to turn to you for solution throughout 2017. In Jesus' name. Lord God, grant me your abundant grace to turn to you for solution throughout 2017. In the name of Jesus. Then pray this one again. I'm running through them, then we pray all them together. Father of all grace, fight for me swiftly and speedily as you fought for Judah. In the name of Jesus. Father of all grace, fight for me swiftly and speedily as you fought for Judah. In Jesus' name. Father of all grace, fight for me swiftly and speedily as you fought for Judah. In Jesus' name. Please, you can walk about. Don't kneel down or you sleep. I don't want you to sleep off. Father of all grace, fight for me and my family swiftly and speedily as you fought for Judah. In Jesus' name. Oh Lord God of Jehoshaphat. See, Jehoshaphat, the meaning of the king's name. His name worked for him. The meaning of Jehoshaphat is the Lord had judged. So, oh Lord God of Jehoshaphat, judge all my enemies swiftly and speedily in Jesus' name. Oh Lord God of Jehoshaphat, judge all my enemies swiftly and speedily in Jesus' name. Oh Lord God of Jehoshaphat, judge all my enemies swiftly and speedily in Jesus' name. Oh Lord God, give me the spirit of worship and the garment of ceaseless praise for the remaining days to the end of 2016. In Jesus' name. Everybody be on your feet. Oh Lord God, give me the spirit of worship and the garment of ceaseless praise for the remaining days to the end of 2016.
In Jesus' name. Oh Lord God, give me the spirit of worship and the garment of ceaseless praise for the remaining days to the end of 2016. In Jesus' name. All battles of the enemy, all the battles the enemy has prepared awaiting me in 2017, Lord, I hand over to you. For I believe you are mighty in power to fight for me and my family. In Jesus' name. All the battles the enemy has prepared awaiting me and my family in 2017, Lord, I hand over to you. For I believe you are mighty in power to fight for me and my family in Jesus' name. All the battles the enemy has prepared awaiting me and my family in 2017, Lord, right now, I hand over to you. For I believe you are mighty in power to fight for me and my family. In Jesus' name. 2017, by your grace and power, Lord, grant me quietness and rest all around me and my family. In Jesus' name. 2017, by your grace and power, Lord, grant me and my family quietness and rest all around. In Jesus' name. 2017, by your grace and power, Lord, grant me and my family quietness and rest all around. In Jesus' name. Oh Lord, my God. Oh Lord, my God. Lead me into great riches and wealth you have for me. In Jesus' name. Oh Lord, my God, lead me into great riches and wealth you have for me. In Jesus' name. Oh Lord, my God, lead me into great riches and wealth that you have for me. In Jesus' name. Oh Lord, 2017, grant unto me a new zeal, passion, and desire to seek you first and your kingdom. In Jesus' name. Lord, year 2017, give me your fresh passion, new zeal, fervency, and the desire to love you, serve you, seek you and your kingdom. In Jesus' name. Lord, Lord, the year 2017, grant unto me, by your grace and power, the desire to love you more, to serve you more, to reach out to souls more than this year. In the name of Jesus. 2017. Oh Lord, help me to bring more souls into your kingdom. Use me to be a blessing to many people in 2017. In Jesus' name. Lord, from the beginning to the end of 2017, I shall not be moved. I shall not be afraid. I shall not be confused. By your help, oh Lord, in Jesus' name, from the beginning to the end of year 2017, I shall not be moved. I shall not be afraid. I shall not be confused. I shall not move backward. I shall not fail. I shall not be sick. I shall not lack. By your help, oh Lord my God, in Jesus' holy name, from the beginning to the end of year 2017, I shall not be moved. I shall not be afraid. I shall not be confused. I shall not be sick. I shall not fail. I shall not be ashamed. I shall not move backward, but I will move forward and achieve greater things by your help, oh Lord my God. In Jesus' name. Now all this prayer, let's pray. Reba Baba Sata. Now pray. If I want to take it, we pray one by one. We'll be yet. Pray now. Pray. Everything you have spoken into his ears, so he will do unto you as you are speaking into the ears of the Lord God of hosts. The merciful God, the God of love, so he will do unto you exceedingly abundantly above all you are asking for right now. I decree in the name of Jesus. Oh Lord, I stand in agreement with your children as they are praying, oh God. I stand in agreement with them, and by faith in the Lord Jesus Christ, thank you for a speedy answer. And as many that will listen to this message, listen, watch the DVD, as many that will watch on Periscope, on the internet, on Facebook, and so as many, we watch it on Periscope. Lord, and pray these prayers. Lord, answer them swiftly. Swiftly answer.
the way you answer King Jehoshaphat and Judah instantly, immediately. He called Baba, answer your people. Let God answer that prayer by fire. You answer prayer by thunder. You answer prayer by earthquake. He called Baba. You answer the prayer of Ikoro Baba, Prophet Elijah, Iko by fire. You answer the prayers of King Solomon by fire. You answer by thunder. You answer the prayers of apostles Paul and Silas with great earthquake. Oh Lord, answer your people. Yekoro Baba Baba. Answer your people as they pray into your ears. I join my faith with their faith. Lord, that you will answer speedily. You go by your grace and mercy, by your grace and power, in the name of Jesus. Everyone that will pray this prayer, and those that are praying it right now in the church, and those that will pray when they watch the DVD or listen to the CD, those that will pray unto you on Periscope, on YouTube, on Facebook, oh Lord God, on internet, my Father God, Jebreveria, answer them swiftly, may your grace and power, in the name of Jesus,
Imam breve, pray. Ikata brava, move ba, pray. Ikoromba baba, move ba, pray. Ejo breve lo rebobo zeze breve. Imam breve zeze breve. Imam breve lo rebobo zeze breve. Imam breve zeze breve lo rebobo zeze breve. Imam 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 breve lo rebobo zeze breve. Ye breve lo roma zeze breve lo rebobo zeze breve. Imam breve lo roma zeze breve digaba. Imam braza ta ye jo breve. Imam breve lo rebobo zeze breve digaba ya. Imam breve lo rebobo zoto. So shall it be in Jesus' holy name. Let's pray for your leaders and the Wind and Fire Church. Let's pray that for the remaining days to the end of this year, that even miracles, all miracles that God has prepared for your leaders, your pastors, every member of this Wind and Fire Church, the men, the women, the youth, the children, let us begin to pray that, Lord, tonight, all the miracles, all the blessings that are yet to be received by members of this church and those that are listening and watching, Father, we pray right now, Ikoro Baba, you, O God, that answered the prayers of King Jehoshaphat and Judah. Father, answer speedily in the name of Jesus. Father, we command all the blessings that are yet to be enjoyed, all miracles, O God, that you are yet to perform, that will bring glory to your holy name. Oh Lord, we say, between now and 31st December 2016, we ask for manifestation by your great power, by your mightiness. Pray it in the name of Jesus. The miracles of all the pastors, the miracles of all their families, the miracles of the families represented in this church, the miracles of everyone, Ikoro Baba, listening, watching, Ikoro Gobobo, this prayer session. Oh Lord, I command a release. I command a release. I command a release. I
command a release. I command a release. May the power of Christ Jesus, I ask for manifestation speedily and swiftly. Swiftly and swiftly, swiftly and swiftly, before 31st December, let there be great testimonies, great testimonies that will bring increase into your kingdom. Miracles, don't find the miracles, Ikoto Brevedia, don't find the miracles of expectations coming to pass, desires being fulfilled, manifestation of answers to prayers. Prayers you have prayed from January to today, I command, oh God, by your grace and power, by your mightiness, oh Lord, Ikoroba manifestation that will bring praise and glory to your holy name, that will also bring increase into your kingdom of heaven. In the name of Jesus, Jebrevedia, Ikoroba Baba Baba, Ikoroba Baba Baba. Imam Brevelo Rebabaya, Imam Brevelo Rebabozoto. Oh Father, we give you praise. Lord, we give you praise. Father, we give you praise. Father, we pray for this community. We pray for the city of Rochester. Father, Yikarabababa. Oh Lord, Lord of harvest, send laborers into this city to harvest the souls into your kingdom of heaven. We pray, God, righteousness to reign in the city of Rochester, Minnesota. We pray for righteousness of God to reign in this state and in the entire United States of America. Lord, we pray for your righteousness to reign, oh God. We pray, oh God, for every family that are going through. We pray for divine help. Every family right now that are finding it hard to meet to meet all their daily needs, all their bees. We pray, oh God, from heaven above, Lord, let there be under her showers of blessing. Lord, let it fall. Let it fall. Riches untold. Let it flow unto everyone that are crying unto you for financial blessing. Let healing, oh God, reach out to those that need healing. Let doors be open, and so many that are knocking, oh Lord, for doors of great opportunities. In the name of Jesus, those that desire new things, Father, open the door of new things. Let them walk through it. In the name of Jesus, Lord, we give you praise, oh God. Crown this year for us, the end of 2016, with your great abundance, abundance of peace and joy, abundance of good health and sound mind, abundance, oh God, promotion, elevation, abundance of increase on every side. In the name of Jesus, that no one among us will lack. In the name of Jesus, satisfy everyone, oh God, as you open your hand wide. Satisfy the desire of everyone that are waiting on you, God. We give you praise, we give you glory. We bless you, God. Father, we bring Sunday service before you. Father, we thank you, Iko, for your mighty presence in your sanctuary, in this place on Sunday. Let Iko Robababa, that your fire will fall upon everyone, that you will not leave anyone untouched, that you will draw into your presence. In the name of Jesus, draw them with your cord of mercy and love into your presence, O God. And Ika Rabababa, save soul, heal and deliver on Sunday, O God. And all praise and glory be to your holy name. Father, we give you praise. Give you glory, O God. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. Now, will you begin to wave your hand and bless him? Niko Robababa. We got to close now. Let's bless him. And take the song. He has done great things. I should wave your hand to him. Hallelujah. He has done great things. Hallelujah. He has done great things.
Father, we thank you for the strength you gave us, the grace you gave us to come into your presence. And we thank you for the prayer session tonight. Lord, we bless and worship you for Pastor and Pastor Ms. Dr. Mrs. Aderonke. We thank you for your blessing reaching out unto them in the name of Jesus. We thank you for Pastor and Pastor Mrs. Kwesi. We thank you for all the men and all the women, the youth and children in this church. We thank you tonight as we are spoken in your ears. Lord, so you are already working it out, doing exceedingly abundantly above all we have asked for in this time of prayer. Thank you for blessing us with your presence. Thank you for full manifestation, even of your glory and your power, and answers to all this prayer in the name of Jesus. Praises are waiting you again. Glory, honor, and adoration. As we come back on Sunday, Lord, you will fill our heart with joy. We will come with our dancing shoes. We will bless and worship you. Because you have kept us alive and well to this moment, you deserve all the glory. And that is what we will give to you, God. In the beginning from this moment, thank you for waning upon us, Lord, that spirit of worship and that garment of ceaseless praise from this moment in 31st December. Help us, oh God. We will not stop to praise you until we cross over into 2017. We bless you, oh God. We thank you for all the battles you have fought. They remain fought forever in the name of Jesus. And we thank you for the benefits of the victory we enjoy, the goodness that follow the victory we have received. We adore you, O God. We shall be very grateful. Lord, we will know you and serve you with everything abundance you are releasing unto us. In Jesus' holy name, amen and amen. Pastor.
Hallelujah. We are blessed, amen. We thank the Lord for the encouraging word that has come through his servant. We are grateful, we are thankful for all that he has done. And Father, tonight again or this morning, we are grateful for everything that you have done. We are grateful for the word which has come forth. Lord, that even through praise, warfare is conducted. And we thank you for what that heaven has responded even today. For your daughter, Lord, you've used as an instrument and as a vessel, as she has yielded herself to be used by you, Father. Oh, Lord, will you replenish both spiritually and physically, Lord, virtue that has gone forth from her in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you for every life here. Thank you that all of us matter to you. And thank you, Father, that indeed each and every one of us will have a testimony of your goodness, of your faithfulness, of your kindness, Lord. As we go forth, it's not from your presence we go. Go with us, Father. Watch over us through this night. Lord, watch over us through this day and gather us again in your presence tomorrow, along with many of our brothers and sisters, and indeed meet us here again. We bless you and we thank you. You said you will give your angels charge over us to keep us. In their arms they will bear us up, lest we dash our foot against the stone. Father, as we go, we ask for your angelic release to watch over us, to keep us, to shield us. And the things that have been released already, Father, we call them permanent in the name of Jesus, our Redeemer, we've prayed. Amen. Amen. Go forth in this encouragement and in this blessing you've received. And by God's grace, we will gather here Sunday morning again to praise, to worship, and to hear from him. Hallelujah. And remind your friends and family members who've not been here for a while, let them come and meet the Lord. Hallelujah. God bless you.